Thank you very much. I was just outside in the hallway there a few minutes ago, and I was looking at one of your high school students' pieces of art, Dasha Bao, I think her name is. She's a beautiful, incredible piece of art. It's called Russia Through the Ages, I think. And it's about this princess. The perspective is this princess, and she just paints this princess through the Russian Empire. And, you know, her expressions and how she's looking through the whole Russian Empire. It's beautiful. And the last presentation, the word perspective was also tossed around. And I have a unique perspective in life. I've met a lot of people. I've been in a lot of places. And the way I choose to express my perspective, I guess, express how I feel about what I see, is songwriting. And I learned it. I got it pretty much drilled into me from a young age from all different areas. So what I'm going to first play is a couple songs that really inspired me from artists that inspired me from when I was a young kid. And the very first was my dad, of course, but I got into the blues, and I really got into Eric Clapton. And so I got to meet him one time, and I was so inspired and scared. I didn't know what to say. I just ran, and I gave him a hug. I must have been 10 years old, and I think he had a cold, but he hugged me back. And right around that time, he came out with this record. It was an unplugged record he did, so I thought this would be a good one to... Oh, and I got to plug in. See, I'm unplugged right now. Thanks. That's Brad right there. Give Brad a hand. All right, let's... Thank you. So that was one part of my upbringing, was the blues. And another part was my dad, and, you know, one of the, let's see. Crazy, I'm crazy for feeling so lonely. I'm crazy, crazy for feeling so blue. I knew you'd love me as long as you wanted, and then someday you'd leave me for somebody new. Worry, why do I let myself worry? Wondering, what in the world did I do? I'm crazy for thinking that my love could hold you. I'm crazy for trying, crazy for crying, and I'm crazy for loving you. So I, thank you. So I got a lot of songwriting upbringing. I got a lot of blues. And I started writing my own songs after a while. And perspective is a big deal, you know. If you're able to put yourself in someone else's shoes and you can relate to them, then it's really hard to hate them, you know. And pretty much anybody can put themselves in anybody else's shoes and find something they like about that person, even if it's, you know, if they ultimately don't agree with how they live their life. And so I wrote a song. I put myself in the perspective of somebody else, and that is a moonshiner. So I pretended to be this kid whose grandfather died, and he had to, you know, carry on the business with his dad. And I thought about, well, he might have a hard time keeping a girlfriend, and, you know, it just, it's very similar to music life, actually. I, you know. So this is a song about running moonshine. Here we go. Working on a submarine still. They found him while the mash was still fermenting in the boiler, his back against an oak upon the hill. And luckily my father knew, and I could learn a thing or two about running and securing revenue. Keeping up with changing times, dodging governmental fines, trying to stay alive like people do. Alive, doing fine, running shine. Alive, doing fine,
just run and shine. I met a girl not long ago who may become someone I know if she can handle everything I do. She has to understand that there's a difference between loving me and wanting me to be somebody new. But I know she's a gift as well, a Caroline, a silver bell, and she can give me something that I need. While I'm chased by federal revenuers, executing slick maneuvers, trying to stay alive but living free. Alive, doing fine, just run and shine. Alive, doing fine, just run and
thank you very much. Time goes on, you know, and I write a lot of songs from all different types of perspectives, and I also write from my perspective. I was dating this girl named Georgia for a while, and it was short. She's a great person. No hard feelings. wonderful girl. But her name was Georgia, and I had to go play that song every single night with my dad when I was on the road with him, and so I made it really literally impossible to forget about the relationship after it had ended. And so so I wrote a song called Forget About Georgia. And here it is. Sure as hell didn't love her this much when I met her. Much as I was just captured again and again. She could turn her eyes away and still hold me under. A river of beauty and mystery pulling me in. And then when she told me her name, I knew I would die slowly. I knew I was destined to live with this pain every night. For each night I stand with my father playing our music. We cry out her name and her memory under the lights. And each night I pray, I'll forget about Georgia, 'cause she'll never love me like I know love's supposed to be. Each night I pray, I'll forget about Georgia, but a part of me hopes that she'll never forget about me. Part of me hopes she'll never forget about me. We made love for the first time in a hotel in San Francisco. A night so perfect I try to forget about it now.
Henry Charles is singing her name like rain on my window. And I want to release her, but I can't begin to know how. So I say, Ray, let me forget about Georgia. Cause she'll never love me like I know love's supposed to be. I say, Ray, let me forget about Georgia. Oh, but a part of me hopes that she'll never forget about me. A part of me hopes that she'll never forget about me.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Now, we all have different perspectives in life, and everybody sees life from a different way, but I mean, I've studied so many religions and philosophies, and Joseph Campbell, I love him, you know. I like Rumi, I like so many different things, you know, so many different perspectives on life and what it's all about. There's stuff about Christianity I like. There's stuff about Buddhism I like. You know, it all really ties us together in separation, really. And it's the separation that allows us to realize that we're sharing something. We're separate in something together. The dream, whatever it is, we're all sharing this dream together. And consciousness itself, the awareness of being alive, of being I exist, maybe isn't, it doesn't matter what body or what form you take when it's happening, so much as it matters whether you can appreciate that that all forms are part of the same dream, maybe, you know? And so I wrote a song. So what if we had to start over? You know, what if after we die we just come back? What if we have to do the same dream again until we learn the right lessons? You know, or what if we're just manifested into some infinitely vast alternate universe, and we have to live another life that maybe looks just a little bit like this one? It's not quite the same. You know, just infinite possibilities. What if in the next time I regain consciousness after I go to sleep and I awake, I'm in the audience watching Lukas Nelson on stage, and I'm one of you guys. We're all sharing this dream. So I wrote a song called What If We Had to Start Over? If I started over. We had to start over. What if the end never ends? What if our lives are not a straight line? Infinite faces, infinite minds. What if we all are just dreaming? How would we deal with our pain? Would we be playing these sad little games, destined to come here again and again? And why are you on my mind? It's that feeling again, like when I first looked in your eyes. If I started over, I'd welcome you in. I wouldn't be scared of facing the end. If I started
start it over, I'd find you again. And what if we all are just dreaming? What if we're ruled by our screens? What if emotions are chemical games? Why am I here? And why do I sing? And why are you on my mind? It's that feeling again, like when I first looked in your eyes. If I started over, I'd welcome you in. I wouldn't be scared of facing the end. If I started over, I'd find you again. I'd find you again. I'd find you again.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I'd like to leave you with one more from Clapton, because just that record really changed my life. I love it so much. And this song I can relate to right now, so I think I want to sing it. I appreciate y'all listening, and thank you very much for having me, Ted. And thank you very much.
I've been running on faith. What else can a poor boy do? But my world will be right when love comes over you. Lately I've been talking in my sleep. Can't imagine what I'd have to say, except my world would be right when love comes back my way. Running on faith, and all of our dreams would come true. Yeah, my world would be right when love comes over you. Seems like my running on faith. And all of our dreams would come true, and our world would be right. Love comes over you. When love comes over you, when love comes over you, when love comes over you, I said, when love comes over you.
Thank you all very much. Thank you.